So good day to you all. This was a drawing that I did last. Well, I was trying to sketch it last night. It's like a zombie, with like a window behind, just smashing through us because someone's like shoved a pipe right through the back of his head, and lots of blood and glass going in his head and stuff like that. Still got to wink the rest of the zombie figure there, but yeah, I just thought I'd show you that. Because I'm quite happy with the way it's going. All the glass and everything, and yeah. Something different there. Awesome. So today I've got the airbrush out. I managed to find it in my shed, full of spiders in there, cobwebs everywhere. So I haven't used this at all. I've never used an airbrush, to be honest. Just a cheap airbrush. There's no compressor except some airbrush propellant, which I'll use, and a selection of basic paints, just the basic colours. So what I want to try and do is test this out on an illustration, but I'm going to try and do a background, for an illustration. I'm just going to prepare the picture and just see how it goes, really. Just test it out in the vlog. Why not? Yeah. So, I'll get this set up and we'll have a little go. Right, so first things first, I've just attached that. I've loosened it. I don't want to tighten it because it'll just compress the air out of there and waste it all. But first, I need to just angle this at the drawing that I'm going to do. As you can see, put a sheet of tracing paper over the top. So what I'm going to do is just going to trace that outline and cut out a template that I can maybe stick on here, and it'll keep all this protected against, the rest of the paint I'm going to use. I'm going to try and do like a red with blue, so it might make a purpley type effect. I don't know, it might not work out how I want, but you never know until you try. So I'm just going to trace this out. Just going to find a pencil and not the camera again, as I always do. What a nugget I am. Yeah, so let's be careful just to get this, and I'll just try and follow all the outline. That's all I want, really, the outline. Bit nervous about using an airbrush, but I guess you never know until you try and just try new things out. In time, I do want a proper air compressor for the airbrush, but we shall just see. I'll maybe do the outline underneath there as well. Oh, snapped. As long as I've got the basic shape, I can just yeah, then what I can do now is just cut out this. Move that pen, don't need that one. Cut out this and then place over the top. Line it all up and then tape it down or something, I don't know. Probably not tape it down actually. Oh, I know what I could do. Yeah, I could do like a couple of masking tape, little hinges, and just one there, one there, and that'll do. Yeah, so that's what I'll do. So I'll come back in a minute once I've done that. So I've cut the shape out there. I just have to line it up and make sure it stays in place. Yeah, so I did think about using a slight bit of masking tape, like I said, and just create like a little hinge. then. Could rip the drawing, but I don't know. Maybe not press it down too much. In fact, I'll just do one piece like that. And then I'm ready to set this little thing up. This airbrush. So, got the compressor there, got the tube where I can put some paint in. I need to make sure that goes down to the bottom. Long enough that, really. Don't really want to use too much paint, really. See what it says. Shake well, untouched, water resistant when dry, close cap after use. I may need to read the instructions. So it's fairly straightforward. I've just put a tiny bit of water in there in the bottom, just to, it might make it more watery though, but I'm just going to test it out. Let's give it a shake. Squeeze a bit in. I'm just going to fix this to that little bottle and then we'll be good to go. Add a bit more water in there. I'll be back. Right, so hopefully that's the right amount. Yeah, pipe goes in there. I'm just screw this on. And then that's the button to use. Once everything's ready. Right, let's put that there. Is it going to stand up? There we go. Stay. So I've just stopped on the window because you need to have a well ventilated room with this. It probably will be a bit noisy, I think, so because the camera's right near this, so just move that slightly down a bit. So I'm going to use the red colour first, and then what I'll probably have to do is wash this out when I've used it all, which is a sort of a waste of paint, but it's quite a bit there. Unless I can reuse it, I've got another bottle somewhere. I think there was another one in there. Yeah, so what I'll do is I'll switch this on. And we're ready to go. Ooh. Shrinking the. Oh well. Well, that first test was a load of bullshit. Yeah. I thought I could use that quick tracing paper for it, but as you can tell, I haven't used an airbrush before. So, yeah. That's that out of the window. Oh well, I need to get some proper frisket and just have a go with that. That shouldn't shrink or curl up. Yeah. Awesome. Can probably save that drawing, perhaps. Yeah, well. So I'm going to try again, and maybe I can, any bits that go over, I can just paint. Maybe with white and stuff. I just want to test this out just to see for backgrounds, really. So I'll just turn this back on. I want it to have an arty effect anyway, so. Bit loud, but there we go. Let it all dribble. Yeah. Look pretty cool actually. Ended up blocked or something. Just turn it off. Yeah, not too happy about the pink colour. First results, shite. I really need a compressor for this. I'm not happy with the results at all. Some fingerprints, greasy fingerprints, distorting the thing. Nah, it's utter shit. I don't think I'll be using this a lot. And the paints are utter wank. Oh well, I thought I'd try it. But yeah, I'm going to need a compressor, I think, and better paints. So, oh well. Probably ruin that drawing. Or I can just cut it out and put it on. Yeah, I'll probably cut it out and yeah. Awesome. The day's going off to a flying start. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna try and jazz it up or make it even worse. What a day. Chuck them on there. I'm gonna try and just put a bit of this Liquitex stuff on and we'll see what's what. Let's get some more water there. Water it out. Yeah, I'm gonna make it worse, folks. But there's always, yeah, today's not a good day. Yeah, definitely not. Trying to get rid of these fingerprints under here. Just trying to get rid of them. Now they're showing up even more. And then there's some idiot laughing out there again. I think I may just save this with a a light blue background. We'll see how it goes. So yeah, what I'll do is I'll let this dry and then around the edges I'm going to do like a black and then try and blend it in with some more blue. And I possibly could save this drawing from that airbrush disaster. But yeah, I think in the future I'll do airbrushing and just test it out on a shit drawing. Do that first, but you live and learn. Make mistakes like that, or things don't work out the way you want them. It's part of life. I don't really stress out about it anymore. You know, as a kid, I used to, if I couldn't draw something, I used to get frustrated and have a little temper tantrum or something when I was a kid. But it's pretty pointless, really. You just got to practice and test things out and see how they go. But yeah, I want to get rid of these fingerprints. I didn't know they'd like show up like that. Fingerprints there, so I'll probably do like a black, try and cover them up, and then add some more blue and just mix it up. Try and save the drawing at least, and then go from there. So today's vlog is trying to save a drawing from fucking up. So I'm just attempting to go back now. I've twisted this piece there, which lifts it up a bit, so it might make more of a like a splatter. Just still experimenting, really. Making more of a mess, but still having a go. So I just think I'll quickly sketch something. A bit different, well, a bit samey, but we'll see. I just had the idea of like two skulls, sort of, that are part of each other, and they're all joined together with lots of, I don't know, like flesh and things. I don't know. I'd just rather go with a random idea after that airbrushing mess up. Never mind. I just need to practice airbrushing and just see how I can improve things in the future. And I think a proper air compressor would do, and paints I'm not too bothered about. Maybe some better acrylic paints. I could use the Liquitex ones, but I don't want to waste a lot of the paints there. So I'm attempting to draw something here. I'm going to zoom in because you can hardly see out. So there, these skull things all might make them like demons, demon skulls. All this like flesh, this is sort of like connected to the other skull, and then really demonic looking skulls. Move it up slightly just to show you the bottom half of this. See, it's a random looking quick sketch at the moment, but I hope to turn things around and I don't know, make it a decent illustration after that airbrushing incident. But then I don't totally ruin the drawing anyway, the Hellraiser Cenobite drawing. Chatterer. Haven't really ruined it too much, really. It's just at the side of me, I'm just looking at it, and yeah. I'll press on and do some more painting with it later on. And I'll try and show you the drawing as it unfolds. But for now, it's these two skulls. loads of detail. So even though this week pretty much I've had a little bit of a stress on, but next week is half term, so I'd have to get up early, but I'm going to make an effort and get up early and just see to these vlogs for the next week, maybe try and do them early. And yeah, just carry on with them. I'm not gonna stop doing these. So I think it's important that I just continue drawing, improving, trying new stuff out, getting better at airbrushing. Definitely, that is one goal. But then it was the first time using it, so it's, you know, I'll just know not to use like tracing paper as sort of like a cover for the thing, because it just shriveled up a bit. So, but yeah, you live and learn. Just about improving in ways and trialing stuff out. That's all it's about. So yeah, skulls. Maybe I'll add the. I'll get a Sharpie marker and I'll start to add lots of dark areas to this. Try and flesh it out a bit more now. Sort of drawing in like jagged, wobbly lines. I'm doing that on purpose. It's part of the style of the skulls. So a lot of this is rotten and stretched like flesh, skin and other stuff, so we want some darker areas in between. I'm sort of like loosely following the pencil lines, but I'm trying to go my own way of inking these details. These eyes here. Could add like other elements to it, you know, later on I can draw more details and, you know, a lot of connecting sort of tissue and flesh and stuff here and there, and I will do it with different ink pens, thinner ink pens as well. So I've just got an O3 Unipin. I'm just gonna sketch in the teeth there and any other thin details. A mixture of thick and thin lines, as always. So as you can see, I'm fleshing it out now. Trying to keep the structure to this. I'm trying to expand on these stretched fleshy bits. Building it up anyway. Yeah, so it's nice to do a drawing that I like and I'm happy with after a little artistic mess up. Layering a load of hatching just to show the shadowed area where the cheekbones are. I always seem to do that for some reason. Oh, I forgot about the shadow area in the skull nose. Drawing loads of details. So when you're drawing like loads of details like this, sometimes it's best just to just, you know, see if all these details work out, and then you can fill in areas, darken areas, and just see how the drawing goes. Sometimes it won't work out the way you planned, but I think this one's working out just fine, I think. Fleshy bits there, something dripping off there, and then there's some bits there. Yeah, so I've got the sort of bug of just experimenting, and I'm going to experiment more with this, but with Liquitex. I've got transparent raw umber, which will be like a dark brown, but I'll try and add a bit to this and just see what it looks like, really. It's be honest. Just a little bit of this in the palette. A bit more. So yeah, put some on the brush. Just gonna layer this up and just let it all drip into one. See where all the drips can go, and they fall down like that. But experimental, I like experimenting sometimes, it's good to do. And this, like, raw umber colour, this dark brown, I can colour over it and, you know, add other colours. It's not going to be like the final colour of this. I might as well spread that out so I can go over that anyway. I'm going to do the same one there, because all I really want to do is just provide a sort of undertone type colour. Get some of them drips. It's fun, all fun. Let's get some darker pieces. I think I'm going to continue this tomorrow, this one. So I'm going to end the vlog there. Sort of like a little snippet of today's events. Don't mention the airbrush. No, I already mentioned it quite a few times, I'm only joking. Just, you learn from your mistakes. And yeah, I'll just leave it in the vlog. I don't care. I'm still an artist learning myself, really. Trying to experiment with different ways of creating artwork, a lot more than I used to when I was at school. I just drew stuff, coloured pencil, that's all I really did, and that's all I really thought that, you know, art was about, really, just choosing a medium and sticking with that. But now I realise testing out different ways of working, you can really combine mixed media stuff and produce some real good effects. So that's really what I want to experiment more with within these vlogs, and finish a load of artwork. Most definitely. So anyway, I'm going to leave it there. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now!